While Shane McMahon is a physical wreck, The Undertaker is an emotional wreck.
Frustrations that you just saw were from the fact that The Undertaker knows it wasn't Shane McMahon. And if you're in a situation like that, you probably want to resolve it as quickly as possible, needless to say. And The Undertaker realizes he's not even close.
Well, as Steve Blackman starts off here against a young man named Steve Lumpkin, Steve Blackman's going to look to demonstrate some of his martial arts abilities. A little bit later on, we're going to show you what happened on SmackDown as Chris Benoit and Chris Jericho were defending the tag team championships against Mr. McMahon and Stone Cold Steve Austin. We'll see how others got involved in that matchup as well. As Lumpkin kind of glances Blackman with a dropkick after Blackman missed a dropkick of his own.
I'll tell you what, the Big Show got a little bit of revenge on Chris Benoit after what happened on Raw.
When a 7'2", 500-pound giant becomes angry and motivated.
Oh! In my estimation, believe it or not, in two losing efforts, I have not seen the Big Show look as good as he did this week.
A lot of people have said the same thing. The matchup with Benoit on Raw was tremendous.
Say that three times.
Yeah, exactly. And then the effort given by Rhino and the Big Show, albeit because of, you know, acting on orders from Mr. McMahon to try to soften up Benoit and Jericho.
Oh!
Oh, Lumpkin's head went squarely into that top step. That is all steel, and there is no give.
So you want to be a wrestler, do you, kid?
Boy, oh boy, there are some lessons being taught here this week on Metal. A little bit later on, Raven and the One Billy Gunn are in tag team action, taking on X-Factor. X-Part, just incredible. You know Big Bad Albert's going to be with him as well.
It won't be long before Big Bad Albert will be headlining.
And it could be Kane looking for a piece of Albert after what went down Thursday on SmackDown. A Baldo bomb on the Big Red Machine. Can't believe I'd ever say those words. Back of the elbow. And now Blackman showing off a little bit, Michael.
Oh, he's got time to. Lumpkin's just being lumped around the ring.
Boy, what a time Jesse Ventura, the governor of Minnesota, had on Monday night at the Target Center in Minneapolis.
Yeah, he was showing off his power. You just talk about Blackman showing off. What Jesse have to get involved for?
Well, Governor Ventura came down to ringside at the insistence of Mick Foley. Mr. McMahon, we know, was trying to wriggle off the hook of those Mick Foley-owned contracts signed while Mick was still the WWF commissioner.
Well, that's true, but I still look at it as abuse of power.
Well, I mean, in Jesse Ventura, here's a guy who won't hide from the people. And, of course, he's not one of these stodgy government guys who just hides behind his power. And he has always loved to be a thorn in the side of Mr. McMahon.
Yes, he has, and he always has been. And you're right about that. He doesn't hide from his constituents. You walk through the airports, there's a Jesse Ventura t-shirt, governor t-shirt over here. He's a self-promoting... I won't go there.
Well, easy now. And, of course, Jesse Ventura's involvement led to Stone Cold defending the World Wrestling Federation champion. Wow! Looking down to the back of his head, but somehow finds a way to roll Blackman up. Near fall.
Man.
And now, look at Lumpkin gets out of his feet.
Put him out of his misery, Blackman.
As I was saying, Jesse Ventura's involvement led to Stone Cold against Chris Jericho. Mick Foley was himself a surprise as the special guest enforcer referee outside the ring. Commissioner William Regal got involved, and it eventually led to Stone Cold Steve Austin getting the 1-2-3 victory over Chris Jericho. But would history repeat itself on SmackDown with the tag team titles on the line? This one, thankfully, is over.
Kevin, are you conveniently forgetting something about the matchup on Raw between Y2J and Austin? Mick Foley is the reason Y2J lost?
Well, Mick Foley answered those questions from Chris Jericho. I know that Mick had a lot of questions himself about his involvement in that match on Monday that found Stone Cold Steve Austin still the World Wrestling Federation champion. Steve Blackman is your winner here on Metal View.